We interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
Hey Boppers! So Friday, June 14th is World Blood Donor Day. Whoop whoop! A day set aside where we can all go and give blood to help save lives and to help end the shortage of blood supply. In my city, the Atlanta United FC has teamed up with the American Red Cross, and they will be at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. to make it so easy for anybody that wants to donate blood to do so. So let's all go give some blood. You're gonna make more anyway. Hey Boppers, welcome to, I think this is the first official like lollipop demonstration that I've done for you. So welcome to the channel. If you have not done so yet, please subscribe. In honor of World Blood Donor Day, which is June 14th, I am going to make for you pretzel rod syringes. So I actually make these quite often for a lot of my clients, and it's usually for like doctor's offices or like med spa offices. They're very cute, very fun, and they look just like humongous edible syringes. This is super simple, and I'm giving you this demonstration 2 days before Blood Donor Day so that you can make some for yourself and for your friends. Okay, here we go. First thing you're gonna need for pretzel rod syringes would be pretzel rod. Come on now, that was obvious, I know. Next up, you're gonna need melting chocolate. So we've got candy melts here in white, pink, and black. So the white is for the majority of the syringe. It's kind of like the top part of the syringe. The pink, I'm using that as like the liquid injection part of the syringe, and you can change the color to whatever you want it to be. The black, you only need a few black, and the black is actually to make the lines on the syringe. But to go along with the black candy melts, you will need one Ziploc bag, and you're gonna melt it in the bag and snip the tip, and you'll be able to draw your lines with that. Also gonna need peach rings, gummy peach rings, and gummy lifesavers. And then we've got fondant. It's colored gray. If you don't buy gray fondant, you can of course take a little bit of black and a lot of white and make the perfect gray. So that is actually for the needle of the syringe. So you'll notice that I keep it covered because I don't want my fondant to dry out on me. So I've melted my chocolate, and how I did that, I took the candy melts, I put them in the bowls, and then I put them in the microwave 30 seconds at a time. I stirred, and this way you keep doing it until your chocolate melts and it'll melt more evenly. All right, so from here we can start building our pretzel rod syringes. Are you ready? I'm gonna grab my pretzel rod and a peach ring, and I'm gonna go ahead and put the peach ring on, slide it down about a third of the way, and now I'm going to grab my gummy lifesaver and very gently place it towards the top of the pretzel rod. Now we're gonna start dipping. So I'm gonna start with the white melted chocolate first, and we're gonna dip the top of the syringe into the white chocolate. So that's gonna be covering all of the candy. And we're gonna start dipping. Of course, you're gonna have to give it a little tilt. Use my spoon to kind of drizzle the chocolate over the rod. And you wanna cover about 2/3 of the pretzel rod. Let the excess drip off. And then move on to your next rod. We did the second dip of the white chocolate, and now, before I actually dip the bottom half of the pretzel rods into the pink, I want to roll out the needles for the syringes. And that way, they'll be ready when we do our second part. So you don't need that much fondant at all. If you just take a little bit, roll it out, and then kind of roll it out on the table. It works much better if you have a silicone mat, but my silicone mats are ratchet and raggedy, and I would not dare put them on camera. Look, I got good rolling hands. One needle. This is something the kids could do. So you want them to be a little crusted over when you actually put them on the pretzel rod, but not too much. I need 6 needles for my 6 pretzels. Bam! Now that our chocolate is dry, We can start dipping into our pink. The pink again is going to represent the liquid that's inside the syringe. And thankfully we don't have that much to dip, so I'm just going to swirl it around and around. But you will need to do two dips on this also. I mean, you did two dips for the top. It's only fair to do two dips for the bottom. It doesn't have to be perfectly even because this is a more whimsical take on a syringe. You don't want it to be so accurate that people are like, oh, can I eat it? Of course you can. Like, it's chocolate, it's pretzels, and it's candy. Why wouldn't you want to eat that? And all together? That's like the perfect combination, is it not?
Yes, it is.
I'm telling you. You do want to make sure that you don't have any pretzel exposed, because that's actually what keeps your pretzel nice and fresh. First dip your pretzels and then you lay them down on the paper. Of course, there's going to be some chocolate that pools around. This is the excess chocolate. Can't get rid of all of it, but I have never had a customer complain that there was too much chocolate on their pretzels. All right, I'm going to let that dry for a second and then I'll do the second dip with the pink and then I'll show you how to put the rest of it all together. All right, ready to second dip? The bottom half. So we are second dipping the pink chocolate now, and right after I second dip the pink chocolate, I am going to show you how I put on the needles. Quick dip. So before your chocolate actually sets, we're going to take our needles, and they're not quite firm yet because we just made them maybe like 15 minutes ago, and you're going to kind of push them into the chocolate. If your chocolate does set up on you, you can just dip your fondant needle into some more melted chocolate and then attach it to the syringe that way. Next up, go get those black candy melts that I showed you earlier. Put them inside of a Ziploc bag and melt them. And this time, instead of 30 second intervals, you're going to melt it with 20 second intervals because you don't want to burn through the bag. All the chocolate's firmed up, so now I'm going to make the measurement lines that go on the syringe, because right now they look super cute, but this is going to make them look even better. So, you got your bag of candy melts? Okay, I do too. Now, make a little space at the end on the corner, and then you're just going to snip the tip. If you have a piping bag, you can certainly use a piping bag instead of a Ziploc bag, but I just want to make this easy on anybody that wants to make these at home and let you know what your options are. So here we go. Let's start making these lines. My chocolate is warm, but it's not hot. The lines kind of alternate, like short, long, short, long. Ta-da! I'm going to finish the rest and I will show you the end product. Look at these. They're the finished pretzel rod syringes. Are they not the cutest thing ever? Like, they're functional and they're edible. Not really functional, but they're definitely edible. So I want you all to try these at home. It's pretzel rods, it's peach gummy rings, it's gummy lifesavers, a little bit of fondant, and a lot of chocolate. You all try this at home. Let me know what you think. Check them out.